The podcast you are listening to of Holmberg's Morning Sickness is brought to you by my friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Trust me on this one. You've had barbecue before, but you haven't had it this good. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale, ericsfamilybbq.com.
When was the last time you had really good Texas-style barbecue? Eric's Family Barbecue, the way it's supposed to taste. Always delicious, never rushed, and prepared to perfection. Eric's Family Barbecue uses only 100% fresh meat, slowly smoked over mesquite wood until it's juicy and delicious. We all know their brisket is the best, but have you tried their pulled pork, pork ribs, or rib tips? Amazing, and their sides are all house-made. Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat. Make the trip. You won't be sorry. Go to ericsfamilybbq.com for more information.
This man needs medical attention.
Holmberg's Morning Sickness.
The old method of treatment for a person in this condition was to throw him in jail.
It's just about that time for us to go. Got to get the entertainment drill involved right now, and then we'll get on here. And the entertainment drill is brought to you by our friends at reactdefense.com. Somebody brought it up this morning. We talked about the TikTok challenge. How much the teachers could use a little tactical black self-defense right now. How great would it be if we had a trained teacher dealing with these knobs in this new TikTok challenge where you're supposed to grab your teacher's ass or smack him on the ass. Smack an administrator in the ass. Which is a felony assault to do that against someone's will. Remember that, what was that, marathon and that guy reached out and smacked that reporter in the ass?
Yeah.
Got a charge against him because you can't do that, and that is illegal to do. So teachers...
That pastor?
And he was... Yeah, that's right. Wasn't he religious?
He's in the clergy.
Jackass.
I just didn't think it was any big deal.
Anyway, it's the new TikTok challenge. So teachers, I look at you and I think, how have you guys not jumped on this tactical black thing immediately? I would do it if I was you in a second just for the off chance I get to punch one of those little rat bastards. But that's not what it's about. It's about making sure that you're safe. And if somebody out there decides to get all squirrely with you and do the TikTok challenge, you can spin on them and defend yourself immediately because you never know when that's going to end. Anybody willing to breach your space with contact might have bad intentions. Do you know what to do if they do? And that's what they teach up there at reactdefense.com. Just great people doing great things, putting tools in your toolbox that hopefully you never get to use. But you know what? It's always good to have them. I got a whole bunch of wrenches I've never used, but I'm glad they're there. And that's the same thing with self-defense. Plus, you're going to get in great shape while you're doing it. I'm a 49-year-old man who is happy that I have stomach muscles. Not all of them, Brady. I don't have all of them. 4 to 5.5. I'm pretty happy with that right now. And that's all because of these guys putting me through the ringer and training me the proper way. That's what you do. You get in great shape. You start running around and doing good things. And you look better, feel better, and just are better. ReactDefense.com. Phoenix, Glendale, Chandler. It's the home of Tactical Black. Brady Entertainment.
Yesterday was a bad day for Mark Zuckerberg. It all started Sunday night when a former employee named Frances Haugen.
The blower.
Yeah. She wanted to do a 60 Minutes interview. Talked about how Facebook intentionally knew some stuff that was going on. Like Instagram was, it found out increasing suicidal thoughts and eating disorders among young girls.
Guaranteed.
Yeah, they really didn't do anything about it. They had a choice between editing some content that would go on there.
And they got some info on that.
Right. And they said basically the clicks outweighed the, you know, what's going to get us more.
But they got like scientific research
they
back
did.
That said, yes, it is absolutely linked directly to. So this is.
So people are guesstimating. Like there's yesterday's shutdown that happened yesterday afternoon.
Yeah.
Facebook, Instagram.
It was odd timing. It was like 8 hours.
It was out like 6 hours, yeah. I think. So by 4 o'clock, they lost $60 million in revenue.
Jeez.
$13 million per hour, $220,000 a minute, and Zuckerberg's personal net worth decreased by $7 billion.
Well, the dangerous thing is with numbers like that, you start screwing around with that business. And our economy starts looking like it's going to get bounced.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, the stock markets are already kind of weird because of rumors and stuff. But, yeah, if you start seeing social media is going to take a $13 million an hour hit because it's bad. But if what you're saying is real and they have scientific evidence that says, hey, you guys have been neglectful in the idea that this actually does cause problems.
You chose to go this route rather than clearing some stuff out.
It's hard, though.
Filtering.
And I hate social media. I think there's a direct link to the way people think and behave. It's hard, though. Like, smoking was a physical, tangible thing you picked up, put in your mouth, inhaled. The damage was obvious. This is mental. So some people will be stronger and some will be weaker. When smoking lied to us years ago and had to pay all that money because they knew it was cancerous and they kept telling us it was kind of healthy or harmless, they got in big trouble. If Facebook runs into that, oof. You won't. Does Kirby have all that? You don't let your daughter?
No. She'll watch some stuff on YouTube.
Because that one just showed me, the K Pearl 21, and everybody's going to run to it now that I said it. She caused an eating disorder in me. I was going to go get some more M&Ms, but I saw her abs, and I'm like, never mind. It definitely, like, when you see that much beauty, especially filth and everything else, you start getting a distorted view of yourself.
And that much food on there.
Yeah.
They show a lot of food.
You see a lot of food. I'm not going to say that's everybody. But, yes, it's very difficult. But I see those filters, and body dysmorphia is a very real thing. How you get there is different every time, but that's a very real thing.
How their lives are just amazing, the places they go.
Right. But, again, that's a slippery slope because maybe you were just a basket case to begin with.
Speaking of, someone started a petition to change the name of Lee County, Florida, to Bruce Lee County.
Yeah, do it.
Because it's after Robert E. Lee originally.
Oh, it was?
Yeah.
So Bruce Lee, who spent no time there.
Yeah. And it says, good thing, continue the battle to eradicate racism in the United States.
Can we just do Kathy Lee County? At least she's, you know, modern.
Clint Eastwood won $6.1 million.
Hold on, I'm not done. She's also an accomplished dancer. I guess so was Bruce Lee, though.
Bruce Lee.
Very good dancer. Although, zero on the scale of really what he did. He was just a really good dancer.
I still lean towards the Bruce Lee.
Excellent dancer. As far as entertainment goes, both very quality entertainers. As far as skills and fights go, Kathy Lee would win. Because Bruce just dances.
Clint Eastwood won $6.1 million. He had a judgment against a Lithuanian CBD company that was using his likeness. And then Shannon Doherty won $6.3 million in her lawsuit against State Farm, which refused to pay up when her house was damaged in that wildfire in 2018.
Are my rates going up?
Probably.
Pay for one of the kids from 90210's house now?
The Pats game on Sunday got some huge
$40 million.
$28 million.
That's huge. 40, I thought, would be about right because I thought this whole, there's nothing else. A, there's nothing on.
And B,
that thing was so promoted. 28 still massive audience, though.
This is kind of cool. The Lord of the Rings orc mask, one of the masks from the Lord of the Rings. Elijah Wood was on with Dax Shepard, Armchair Expert, his podcast.
Yeah.
And he told about the story how Peter Jackson could not stand Harvey Weinstein. And
oh, no kidding.
So he basically said, I'm not going to confront him on it. I'll just design one of the orc masks
to look like Harvey.
Harvey Wall.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Did Harvey Weinstein do the Lord of the Rings?
Because
if that's the case, then... Well, he's not saying he couldn't stand him because he
thought
he was a criminal.
He talked about how the movies were originally supposed to be made by Miramax.
Oh.
And Harvey and Peter had creative differences.
Uh-huh.
So that's where that
came
from.
So it was just a couple of guys who didn't get along.
Elijah basically says, yeah, he didn't like him, but you know what? Now he's in trouble for what he did. F him.
Yeah, easy to say now.
Yeah.
Thanks, boy who looks like Katy Perry. By the way, Scott Haines is fired off, and he's on his social media. This is a good take. It's like, you know, scientific evidence of Facebook causing the body dysmorphia and stuff. He said, there's also scientific evidence that came out just now of a suicide much higher after watching Brady's Instagram, which is very true. Your responsibility to take that down is growing. Scott and I are the whistleblowers on Brady's Instagram and the scientific.
They tried already.
I know, because so many suicides, and you brought it back.
Get your tickets. New Kids on the Block, Rick Astley, Salt and Pepper, and Vogue.
Pepper.
Salt and Pepper.
Pepper.
Sorry, Pepper.
And En Vogue.
It's called the Mixtape Tour.
It's pretty good.
May 25th, Footprint Arena.
I'm not going.
2022.
I've fallen for this before. I went to Vanilla Ice. Who's the
Funky Cold Medina.
Yeah, Tone Loc.
Tone Loc. The house party guys. The Pajama Jammy Jams.
Tony.
No. Kid and Play. And Salt and Papa were there. And their turntable broke in the middle of their set. And they let
Spinderella busted it up?
Yeah, the rubber band or whatever broke. She couldn't Spinderella. So they went into the crowd and just gave the mic to a guy in the front row. And he started poorly singing Sweet Child of Mine. I'm like, this is awful. And then Tone Loc said,
all you big ladies come on up on stage.
The fattest women I've seen slaughterhouses with a better looking lineup wander up on stage and start getting fat with Tone Loc. And he was sexually assaulting all of them. Every one of them was.
Hey.
It was a tsunami of front butts.
They just, front butt, it would win a like a beauty pageant compared to what was going on with this hog festival.
Funky Cold Medina.
And he'd walk up behind him, dry hump all of them. And they do in this loop where he would just occasionally say it again.
Oh, Funky Cold Medina. Oh, all right. Oh, hey, Kool-Aid. Hey, thirsty kids. Oh.
It was the worst thing I've ever seen.
Some of those shows go to. Those guys show up for 20 minutes.
And they leave.
And then they take off.
Biz Markie did two songs. Like, you got paid for this? Hey, Phoenix, it's my hometown. You got more now. Or it wasn't Biz Markie. It was Rob Bass. It was the other dude. Rob Bass showed up.
Joy and Pain.
Yeah. And he did that one. And then another one I've never heard. And then he was gone.
It Takes Two.
Okay. Anyway, we're done. Let's get the heck out of here. We've posted enough. Somebody just emailed and said, oh, my God, I've been through this before. You're not talking about him. He's not there. Has Brett gone the way of? And I'm like, no. Brett's got a family. Brett is very, very fine here. He's cemented in.
He's got some business in Chicago.
He's got some family stuff he's got to take care of.
Forget about it.
Brett had to go. He's got an aunt and a mom, and some sickness and some stuff and some people seeing each other.
Some kind of ceremony.
Could be some sort of goodbye.
Award.
It is weird when Italian says, I got to take my mom back, say goodbye, sister. No questions. You do that. You got four or five days to take.
That's all I'll need.
So he'll be back. Don't worry. I think he's back Friday. So he's fine. That's it. We're done. Larry McFeely's coming up next. You guys have yourselves a great rest of your Tuesday. We'll see you tomorrow in the morning sickness. So long.
Big, red, and badass.
It's the natural way radio should be.
You've been listening to Holmberg's Morning Sickness Podcast, brought to you by our friends at Eric's Family Barbecue in Avondale. Meet, mesquite, repeat, ericsfamilybbq.com.